Hello, dear viewers. I welcome you almost exclusively in your left ear due to how I'm sitting, to this dark and stormy night. You may actually hear some thunder in the background. Maybe some strong winds, rain, stuff like that. Hopefully, it actually adds to your relaxation pleasure. I know it always really helps me out. I love just listening to rain sounds and distant thunder sounds. I hope you enjoy that. Back with another binaural video. This time, I have a guest. Though I'm sure you've seen the title of this video. So you already know what's going to happen. However, I have a guest with me here tonight to help bring you some more binaural ASMR relaxation sounds. Hopefully, we'll find out. This pad is for my guest. He prefers to have some place nice to sit. My guest is sitting right beside me, just out of frame. A little tired right now, but I'm sure he will wake up in just 1 second. I would like to introduce you to my guest. Just gotta wake him up. Bastion. Come here. Yeah, that caught your attention, didn't it? Face the camera. This is Bastion. My dog. I don't know, he's going back to where he was sleeping. Over here. Let's bring out some more of his toys. Come here. Come here. Come here. Good boy. This is Bastion. He is a dog that I adopted from a local shelter. He is a probably some sort of mix, but he's mostly a white German Shepherd. Now come back. Come here. It's a white German Shepherd. Because he's a little itchy. And he makes hilarious sounds. They estimate him to be about a year old. When they got him, just an estimation. I'd say he's probably between a year and 2 years. A white German Shepherd named Bastion. If you play Overwatch, yeah, that's where I got his name from. Bastion, like the robot from Overwatch. Which I think fits really well, because if you know the game, it's like it's a robot sort of tank, very good defensively, is actually super nice, but can be dangerous. So like a German Shepherd, very good at defense, super nice, but can be dangerous. And also just the word bastion itself means like fortress, guardian, the last bastion of hope, stuff like that. So he's super nice, aren't you, boy? Good boy. He's super nice around people. Has to learn to be better around other dogs. I'll admit that. So he was just found as a stray, by the shelter. No microchip. No anything, really. So they weren't able to locate his family. And I do believe he had a family and wasn't just a stray. Because he knows some commands, like, come here. Knows sit most of the time if he's not distracted. And if he's sitting, he's pretty good at knowing how to shake. So I feel like he was someone else's before, but he was just kind of found as a stray in the middle of nowhere. So, I mean, that's really too bad. I don't know what his life was like. All I can hope now is that his life now is better. I think he likes it here. He gets so much love and attention. And all the toys that he could want. Comforts, like... This gel cooling pad that he likes to lay on because it's nice and cold. Like when we first got him, we bought him a bed to lay on, but he preferred just to sleep on the tile floor because it was cooler. So now, like when I'm in the office, I've got him this pad that he can come and lay on. It's a little bit cooler than just the carpet itself. He has a ton of toys. Like, his pizza. Here you go, here's your pizza. I'm not interested in pizza right now, that's okay. His other toy, just a hunk of meat. Here's your large hunk of meat, Bastion. There you go. Another toy. A Stitch from Lilo and Stitch. A little squeaky character. Here you go. You can have that one too, buddy. There it goes. Yeah, I think the Stitch one is his favorite. It's also kind of late. And he likes to roll over. And he likes belly rubs. He loves belly rubs so much. He can just sleep in this position. The one thing, he doesn't like tennis balls so much. It's kind of sad. My mind has had the dream of a dog that will chase after tennis balls. Let's see if we can make him so you don't just see us. But Bastion, come here. Come here. Turn around a little bit. Good boy. Good boy. And breathe heavily right into the microphone. But don't hit the microphone. Look right here, Bastion. Get a nice close up. Yeah, that's perfect. Good boy. Don't you want a pizza? Good boy. Sit. Shake. You see that? That's pretty good. This pad's a little slippery. It's kind of falling down. Right there, that's a better view. Those nails are kind of hitting my speaker setup. That's okay, that's a better view. But yeah, anyways, so I got a tennis ball for him. He holds it for a second and immediately drops it, or just doesn't hold it at all. But that's okay. I just imagine a dog I could just fetch with a tennis ball. But guess he's not that type of dog. That's okay. He's just ruining my hopes and dreams. There you go. He's tired. He had a long day. It's getting late. We already took him out for a run today. So he's probably all pooped out. Even with all his toys. His pizza. There you go. His Stitch. There you go. His meat. There you go. You can have them just all at once. Okay, I'll put them over here. He loves it if you rub his ears. Usually he makes a sound. Oh, wow. He's a good boy. He's a good boy. He really is. And also about how I was saying, I'm pretty sure he was somebody else's and not just a stray from birth. He hasn't gone to the bathroom inside of the house, which is very good. He seems to know to wait till he's outside or use a doggy door. He hasn't torn up too much in the house. A few things he's been bad about. Twice now he's jumped up onto the kitchen counter, or at least front legs on the kitchen counter, to grab some food. So that was not a good thing that he did. Definitely not. And twice now, he's accidentally locked himself inside of the guest bathroom. And, while we were away. And we came back, and usually he just greets us by the door. But we didn't see him. And we discovered him inside the guest bathroom, whining. And everything was just a mess in there. The tower curtain, or shower curtain rod was torn down. Yep, that's you. The shower curtain rod was torn down. All of our decorations were off the shelf, tissue boxes, everything was on the floor, some shattered glass for a decoration we had. Twice now. Just today we caught him drinking out of that toilet. So, yeah, there's a few areas of improvement. That's for sure. But overall, he's a good boy. Super nice and loving around people. Loves just to snuggle up to you and get pet. So easily likes to get belly rubs. Good boy. If he's too tired, or if I should force him to play fetch. Bastion, look at this. Look at it. You want to play fetch? Go get it. No, okay. He's tired. Oh, man. Now what am I supposed to have you do for the rest of this time? You were supposed to perform tricks, like juggling and pouncing on your back legs. It just follows me everywhere too. If I get up just to do the simplest thing, he'll get up from his nap and follow me around, wanting to know where I'm going. Wanting to see where I'm going, even if it's just nothing. He just wants to be with me, be loved. It's probably too loved at this point. Spoiling him. Got him all these toys. Let's see if there's something we can get excited though. Something we can... See if we can elicit some sort of sound out of it. So I have one of these Kong balls. Unfortunately, he doesn't like to chew it very much. He doesn't like chewing on the hard things. He much prefers the... So he's following this with his eyes now. He much prefers the, soft squishy toys over the hard toys. He won't chew on these for some reason. I don't know, not sure why. But this has, they have some items that you can squeeze into the bottom. So I have this, I don't know if you can see it, bacon and cheese flavored, and you kind of just spray it into the bottom of this ball and they lick it. See if I open this up. Maybe he smells that. You smell that? You smell that? Just spray a little bit of this into here. He wants some. Here, get some. I'll put it down next to one of your ears. Kind of lick the bacon and cheese flavor out of it. It's really good. Yum, yum. Must be awake now. Well, how's that for ASMR? Binaural right in your ear. Dog tongue sounds. That's what you came here for. So I have delivered. He's just licking it clean. What are we going to say? See what he's doing here. Now he's trying to bite it. Ooh, he dropped it. Let's put it down. Put it down. Now he's picking it up. He's trying to pick it up. You got that? All yours. You going over there? No? You coming back? Just gonna set it down and play with it. Okay. But yeah. He's a good boy. A little I don't know, if I had to describe his personality, I might say goofy. The way he sits sometimes, he's super goofy. He just lays on his back with his arms extended. Let's see. I don't know if this will work by that. I just pulled up some pictures. Sometimes you'll lay just like this. Super goofy on his back, one arm or two just in the air. Or upside down with a silly face. So goofy. But I still like him. When he runs, it's super goofy too. My passion. How about this bone? I want you on the bone. Yeah, okay. Yeah, think about it. No. If I give the toy a little squeak, he'll go fetching for it. Okay. Fetch. So brought a few little treats for him in case he was being a good boy. I'll do one more fetch, and if he does it, I'll give him a little treat. But don't tell him I have him yet. Go get it. Come here. Yeah, he sees the tree. Sit. Good boy, shake. I'm not sure if he knows how to shake or if he just shakes all the time. Shake. Good boy. You don't even really have to say shake, he kind of just does that. So I'm not sure if he knows how to shake or if he just does that at all times. You're chewing on that, aren't you? Yeah, sniff right near the microphone. Good ASMR sounds. Good boy. Bunny passion. He gets happy and pants a lot. Hair everywhere though. But he gets pants, he gets happy, he gets pets. He gets whatever he wants. I think so. He's mostly a shepherd. Oh, where are you going? You're the star of the show. Oh, he smells the treats. Let's just put this away. Well, first the bacon and cheese thing. Secondly, the treat bag. You know what you need? You need water. So I got this little travel water. Water bowl. I'm just gonna pour some water in there for you. Drink some nice ice water. Right in there. Good boy. shepherd. The dog was sitting there in the shelter. All other dogs were barking, but he wasn't. Here, have some of it. I put out a whole bunch. Please drink it. Good boy. Well, that's it. Please drink some more. I poured out too much. No. Wait, get away from the chintz. Come on. Come on. Back over here. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Lay on your bed. We'll get the rest of the bacon and cheese, huh? That's a good idea. Good boy. I'm really digging that. Good boy. Good boy. So, he's definitely a good boy. What else can I say? He's a good boy, but you're off screen, Bash. Come here. Yeah, don't you want to be the star of the show? Come here. He just wants to cuddle up next to me. He has this sweet bandana. The red bandana. One of our friends gave him. He looks super rad. I've had him about 2 to 3 weeks now. I know I probably should have made a video earlier, but for the longest time, he was wearing a cone of shame because he recently, got neutered. Lie down. Sit. That's shaking. Sit. Sit. Sit, Bastion. Sit. Sit. Good boy. Good boy. I think that deserves a treat. Here you go. Yeah, so yeah, we're a cone of shame because he just recently got neutered. So we're taking him for walks and taking him out, and he just looked like, I hate to say this, but he looks so dumb. So shameful. This cone of shame. In fact, I was embarrassed for him. If he was going to get his 15 minutes of fame on my YouTube channel, I wanted him to be at his best. I finally got him groomed, all brushed down. He needs a lot of brushes. He sure sheds a lot. It is going from winter to summer, so his coat's coming off, shedding off. But he's nice, super nice. He's my Bastion. He's not scared of the thunder or anything. When he's out everywhere, he's super curious. He has the hiccups. Definitely hiccup once. There he goes. I've never seen him have the hiccups yet. Apparently he only does it when I'm talking too. Have the hiccups? Drink some water, that'll help with that. Here we go. Good boy. Just drink the water upside down, okay? You got that? That's good at killing hiccups. In case you're wondering, he does have his own water station, I suppose. This is usually just when we go out for long walks and hikes or go to a park or something. Just staring into it. Maybe he's seeing the ice cubes and wants to eat the ice cubes. He's not sure what they are. Like he's trying to bite an ice cube. Kind of funny, he's just staring at the water. No. No, don't eat your bowl. He just picked up his bowl full of water. That would definitely have ended badly. Come over here. That would have ended badly, and water would have been spilled all over the carpet. Would you have wanted that? He wants to go fall next to me. But I'm not in camera, so he's not in camera. Yeah, good boy. Yes, thank you, Shake. He's a big dog. Good big doggo. Look up here. At the camera. Yeah, good boy. Sit. 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 He sometimes knows how to sit. Depends on how distracted he is. Good boy. Yes, thank you for the shake. Lay down, it's okay. Good boy. So yeah, dog's a lot of extra responsibility. Super cool, but you know, dog food, he requires a lot of exercise. Things getting broken that we don't want to get broken. But he's fun. He's fun. It's like having another person here. Let me rub your belly, Bastion. Looks up at me. So we can't like this. There you go. Oh, I love it when his tongue hangs out the side of his mouth. That's hilarious. What do you want? What do you want? I guess this episode, or this video, isn't so much about triggers as it is just kind of me rambling about my dog, Bastion. I hope that's okay with you. Was it worth it just seeing a dog? I don't know how much I'll get him involved in other videos. I've recorded a few videos where I've locked him outside of this room, which can be bad. Just have to hope he doesn't scratch the door because he misses me or something. Usually he's pretty good. But like whenever I leave in my car and have to leave without him, he's sometimes I can hear him scratching on the door from the other side, which I obviously don't want him to do. But he misses me. Okay, I can drink a water myself. He's a good boy. You are. You're a good boy. You're the goodest boy. What was I saying? I totally forgot. It'd be better in a few areas. It's good in a lot of areas. Let me know if you have any pets. Oh yeah, I was talking about how he'll act during my other videos. Yeah, so a good thing is, as you can tell, he doesn't bark very much. Pretty much never inside the house. He barks at other dogs, but when he's inside the house, rarely barks. Although a few nights ago, I woke up at like 2:30 a.m. and I'm pretty sure he was barking, and that woke me up. It's like, 20%, it might have just been like a dream. But 70%, I think he barked a little bit, and I got up and was looking around and didn't see anything. He's supposed to be a guard dog, but I'm pretty sure he would just lick any intruder. And become friends with them. I'm pretty sure she would just do that. That's a big breath from a tired doggo. It's all of his toys, but it's time to sleep. The point of that was, won't hear him barking. In the background of my videos, just scratching on the door, maybe. Or I could leave the door open and he can walk in, but that might just create some more sounds if he like shakes around or does something like that. But man, look at all this attention he gets. He gets spoiled. He's one spoiled dog. Yeah, so I don't know when the next video with him will be. Maybe I'll try to get a more up close video. Get the camera down his level. And see what I can do to have him sniff around it. If you put the GoPro on his back, I don't know. Would that work? I'm not sure. Have him run around in the backyard. And this is great because, as you guys know, I had the video where I told you and showed you that I bought a house. So before, I was just living in an apartment, no backyard, nothing really. And I just knew we really couldn't get a dog out there. That just wouldn't make sense. Wouldn't be fair to the dog to have such a small living space and no backyard. So we got the house, decided that, a dog could work. And when we're gone at work or for something else, we don't put him in a cage or anything. He has basically the whole house to do whatever he wants, I guess. Sleep around, walk around in. We don't let him in the bedroom though. It's just one safe area, I guess. Get the dog hair out of there. I'm also slightly allergic to dogs, so this is working out great, but it's totally worth it. Just that way, no dog hair really gets into the... Well, there's still a ton of dog hair, but it gets everywhere. Because there's really no hiding from that. Sometimes when you scratch his ear like that, he does this like moaning sound. This dog does a lot of stretches too after he lays down for a while. Every time he gets up, he just does a big old stretch. He does the downward dog yoga pose and the upward dog, if that's a thing. I know he does the downward dog. He must be tired. Usually he's more energetic. He's got some nibbles. I'm wondering if he has like itchy skin or maybe he got some tick shots. I guess he got all his shots. He got microchipped. Heartworm disease. We should be good on all that stuff. Bash him here. Bash him. Look at the camera. I'm trying to make you famous. Give me your good side. Don't you want to be famous? Got it right here. He's fun to play with, loves to be played with. Big dog. Fun dog. A lot of responsibilities. Yeah, I know what you mean. It's getting late, isn't it, Bastion? But who's been a good boy today? You've been a good boy. Most of the time. Most of the time you're a good boy. Didn't quite get a lot of FaceTime in this video, but it seems you're content to just show off your back in that marvelous coat of yours. He gets a lot of compliments that he's a really beautiful looking dog, and he's built well and such, and I can't disagree. He's a very beautiful doggy. Maybe he'll show up in future videos. We'll see. But I think he's ready for a nap. I think I'm ready for a nap too. Or just, you know, normal sleep, not necessarily a nap. I'm so glad you got to meet my new dog. I really like showing him off. He's super cool. And I love him. I'm pretty sure he loves me. Or he's just using me for my food. This is good. Sleep tight, Bastion. Bastion up here. Bastion. Nah, no point. No point at this juncture. He needs to sleep. Well, thank you so much for meeting my dog. I hope this video has brought you much joy, much relaxation. combination of ASMR and dogs. I mean, how can it get better than that? Frankly, it's going to be really hard to one-up this video. This should get more views than all my sports videos combined. Sorry, I'm getting distracted by petting Bastion. But I'll let you go. Hopefully you're asleep too, or relaxing. And also, if you didn't notice, I'm terrible at goodbyes. I just don't know how to end it sometimes, you know? That's okay. We're in no rush. This is ASMR. We ain't here to do a 10-second Snapchat of my dog. We're here to do a 46-minute biopic. The life and times of Bastion the dog. Coming soon to your Instagram. Just kidding. That was a joke. There's a TV show coming out. Good boy, Bastion. Good boy. You've been good today for the cameras, haven't you? Also, I apologize if this video was entirely broadcasted in your left ear, pretty much. Just the way I was sitting, I suppose. Okay, this time for real. Thank you for joining me. Hope my dog has brought you happiness, like he has brought to me, and I hope to have brought to him. Also, I said brought, and that isn't a word. And also, that was a great ending, and I just ruined it. I hope he has brought you joy, as I have brought to him, and he has brought to me. And there's just joy everywhere. It's addition to this dog. This dog that just a few weeks ago was sitting there in the shelter in the kennel by himself. Sitting up against the gate, looking at everyone that passed by. So happy when we took him out for a walk. And then, one time we took him out for a walk, and he never returned to his kennel. And that was that. He became my boy, my dog. I think everyone's lives have been improved because of that. It's been good. Thank you everybody for watching, and I'll see you next time.